Hello, I'll be showing you the design of Raft Foundation, and I'll be using the Prota 2022 version. So before we begin, I will say welcome to Ekidel, where I will train future civil and structural engineer. My name is Justice Omaka, and I'll be your instructor for today's design of Raft Foundation. Now, looking at this structure right now, you can see that this structure is basically a medium rise building, which is up to 6-story building, as you can see that. So from here right now, we are already done with the design of the superstructure. So basically, knowing that most people don't know how to design a raft foundation or mat foundation using the recent version of this Protastructure 2022. So we're about to, before we want to design for this substructure, which is the foundation design, we intended to now make a video to show you guys how to use this recent Prota 2022 to design for a raft foundation. So currently, and we are going to design this building in two phases. The first one we are going to design is to design using a beam raft foundation. And then the second one is to now show you also how to design for a slab raft foundation. So now you have seen that this is like a long walk, and it will be a very long design because we are designing two type of foundation. So I'll consider, if you are new on Ekidel, you can click on the subscribe button, or and also if you're also an old subscriber, I would say you should turn on your video notification so that you don't miss when we post other parts of this video. Okay, so right now, before we begin, the first thing you have to do is to perform some settings. Some settings are very, very essential before you can begin your design of foundation in this version of Protastructure, and that settings is what I'm going to show you just now. Okay, so those settings right now, we are going to look at for the bearing capacity value and all other settings. So the first thing now we'll do is to go to this place that says here settings here. Now on the settings now, we'll have to click on the foundation design settings. We are going to set in our bearing capacity value, knowing that before you must design your foundation using this current version of Protastructure, you must have before now gotten your value of your bearing capacity. Okay, so from here now, we will now move on to the foundation design here, this foundation here. But before we move on, I would like to bring to you for you to see the code that we are designing to. So we are using Eurocode for this design of this structure, but despite that, anywhere you are, even if you're using Indian code and BS code, ACI and all that, you can still follow the same procedures work for every other design, all right? Design code standard, okay? So right now, we'll now move on to the next phase here and click on what foundation here, okay? Now, if you want to know more about structural design, I would advise you enroll for our Ekidel mentorship class, which is coming up on January 2024. So you can enroll on that. The cost of the training is not really that expensive, $480, but I'll say that your life will be different after the 6 weeks of training, okay? So right now, and if you want to check on that, you can check the link down below and then check the link for you to enroll for our Ekidel mentorship class, okay? So right now, on this place now, the first thing we'll do, once we come to foundation here, the first thing we're going to do right now, since we're designing for a mat foundation, is to now impute our bearing capacity value, which is on this place that says allowable stress of soil. So from here now, I'm going to impute the bearing capacity. So from our soil test, the bearing capacity value for this building is 145 kilonewton per meter square. Now, this other place that says soil vertical surcharge coefficient, I always advise you leave it as this default. Basically, this was gotten from a textbook. This value was gotten from a textbook called Joseph Boyce, and this is the average surcharge coefficient for the soil from lower limit to upper limit. Now, if you can click on it that says now select here, you will see that you can see different values of your soil charge coefficient from lower limit to upper limit. But I would advise you leave it as the value that is there, which is 50,000 kilonewton per meter cube, because except you understand whatever thing that is going on here, which for you to understand it, you will go and read this book. You can see that this software even is also giving you a reference that foundation analysis and design from Joseph E. Boyce. This man did a very good work on when it comes to foundation design. So if you want to know more about foundation design, I would advise you go and read this textbook written by Joseph E. Boyce. Okay. So but from in my own case and experience, I would advise you leave it as this default value here. Okay. Now, again, the next thing now you're going to see right now is your lean concrete, which is said here 100. I want to use 75 for that, although you can choose from 50 to 100, okay? So I would like to use 75 for that. Now, I will leave everything here as default because I don't need all these three footings. I'll leave them because I am designing for a Raft Foundation. So I'll leave them. Then I will now come again right now for this, my reinforcement here. Although I'll still leave these ones as default because I'm not designing for a part fit and that. So I'll leave everything here as default. Now, once you have inputted your soil bearing capacity, as you can see there, and also since we are using Eurocode, you can see that the allowable soil strength factor, which is the factor of safety for foundation, is given as 1.25, which is okay because it comes from the what? From the code, Eurocode, okay? And even we are using BS code, you would have been seeing 1.4 and all that, okay? So right now, once you have done that right now and done the settings, the next thing now to do is now come here and click on what? Okay, okay? That's fine. So with this okay now, once you have done the settings, you have passed the first stage before beginning the design of Raft Foundation or Mat Foundation using the software Protastructure. The next thing now we'll move on to now is now begin the modeling of this substructure, which is the Raft Foundation. And to begin that, we'll have to go back to plan view. And on plan view right now, if you just keep your eye here, you will see that we are currently on story one. Now we will have to move on to story zero, which is the substructure. Okay. Now, before we move on to that first, you must have to go out from this interface called design status. Okay. So by doing that right now, to go out from there, because you always come here when you are done with your design of structure, then you want to now see, how the members how the members like beams and columns and everything are behaving. As you can see right now, we have already performed a personal check on each of the member, which is called interactive design. We have checked all the members, the beams and columns, and everything looks okay. As you can see that everything looks green, which we have also arranged all the bars and all that, okay? So before you must begin your substructure, which is your foundation design, you must first of all finish up everything about the superstructure, okay? So right now, since I'm done with that, I will now move on to this place that says here, plan view here. And on my plan view now, I must have to go out from this interface here. And by doing that now, I'll have to come here that says display here, and then click on this place that says vision interrogation and wait for it to display. Now from here now, I'll now come to this place that says none here and click on none. Although there are other things that you might meant to consider each of these things here, but for this Raft Foundation, it is not needed and all that. And when we are dealing with the slab, raft, we are going to consider FE contours, but until then, I'll show you on that. So right now, come here and click on OK. After I've said none, I'll say OK with that. And then you cannot see that it has not changed from that interface to this interface. Okay. So right now, the next thing now, since I am beginning with the beam raft foundation, so the first thing I'll do is now model this, the beam raft. So how my beams are going to connect and also how I'm going to lay my slabs. Okay. So right now, since I have changed this interface now to the model interface, as you can see there, the next thing I'll do right now is now come here and make my story zero active. Since we are designing for a substructure, I will have to make my story zero active. Now on making it active right now, you can see that only the columns that are visible here. So I will have to come here and turn on my axis layer if yours is being turned off. So turn it on. Okay. Now, the reason that I turned it off before was to get a clearer view of my model, okay? So right now, I want to now begin to make use of these grid lines. I'll have to turn it off. On. So since I've turned it on now, the next thing we'll now begin now is now begin to model for the beams. So right now, I am going to click on this place that says beam here, and then now begin to click in my impute the width of my beam for the foundation. So in this case now, I want to use a beam width of 300 for the foundation, or you can choose a beam width from 225, 250, 275, 300, depending on the size of the structure. Although I always advise, if you're designing, you try to use not the bigger size first, but try to use first the smaller sizes. So right now, I would like to, instead of in 300 first, which is bigger, I'll try 250 first as my width of beam. Then for the depth now, for the depth, which is the depth of the beam, depending on the height of the structure, as you can see right now that the height, this is a 6-story building, as you can see that. This other one here is not counted because this software follows the US methods to count their structure, which they count the G plus zero as 31. Okay, which is not good if you're using BS or what or BS Code or UK or UMC Eurocode. Okay, so right now this is a six-story building, and because of that, the height of this building in total is 24.5 meters. So because of the height of that, although knowing that the minimum depth of raft beam should be 1 meter, that's the minimum depth of raft beam should be 1 meter. Anything lower than 1 meter is no longer called a raft foundation, but it is entering into a wide strip foundation. Okay, but once it's up to 1 meter, then it is called a raft foundation. Now, even at that, once your depth of beam is up to 1 meter, you must not call that beam again. You must not call that member as a beam, but instead it has now turned to a wall. So once your beam depth, either superstructure or substructure, is up to 1 meter and above, that member should be designed as a retaining wall or as a wall. Okay, so now knowing this, now the next thing now will begin is now begin to model our raft beam. But since we have already taken our width to be 250, now the depth, now I want to use a depth of 2.2, which is 2200, depending based on the height of the building. So I want to use 2.2 as my initial depth. Okay, so I'll leave here right now as default, and then come to this other place here. Okay, nothing to do here because we are not designing for a gallery slab and all that, so I'll just leave it right now and then put this in, and then put this in. Now if you want to know more about structural design, I would advise you enroll for our Ekidel mentorship class, because there are some things that we might not be able to say here based on we are trying to gauge this video duration. So I'll say that to do yourself that good, enroll for our Ekidel mentorship class. We will have to train you physical, like using a live screen like Zoom and all that, to train you. So right now I'll begin to model that right now. So in doing that right now, you just use a ground beam to connect all your columns together. Basically, you have to look out for the major beams. Okay, so I'll look out for the major beams now, and then begin to connect all my this thing together. Okay, so right now again, now I can choose to name it FB1 or that, or I can also come here to change the label here. But I can choose to type just call it B1 or arrow B1 and all that. You can choose to change that, but for now this is not that important, so I'll leave it as it is. And then continue again, come here and then click on this place here. Okay, and then come again here and then click on this place here. So always insert your beam column to column. So I'll do again right now, click on this here. Okay, and then come again now, move all the way down to this place here and click this other one here. So I'll just repeat the same thing right now by just following what I'm doing right now. Do this. Okay, and then I will now click on what, escape first, escape, and then continue all the way down from here to here, and from here. So let me just say, okay, from here to here. Okay, let me see. This is the center of the column. Okay, here, let me see. Yeah, it's placed here. Click here. And then from here to here. Okay, and I'll click on escape. Now, if you are new on Ekidel, there is what we call stone bridge templates. Now, the stone bridge template is used after you are done with your design in Protastructure. The stone bridge template helps you to optimize the Protastructure drawing, which does not look nice. So you can, we have made cool videos about stone bridge template. You can really check it out on our channels, or go to Google and type stone bridge template, and then you will see our videos, and then watch on it how that template is very, very important. The link to that together template is also on this video description. You can also get that, or just visit on our site and then you get that also, or chat us up on WhatsApp and we'll guide you on that. Okay, so right now we're going to go again right now and model this and not that to this right now. So knowing that the whole idea is to connect all the beams together, so I can quickly leave you now and then come back when I'm done with the connection. That's just to reduce the length of this video duration and all that. Okay, so I'll be back once I am done with the modeling, and then we'll now walk you through again to the next stage, which is now entering into the slab, because there's a process, there's a way you are going to insert your slab when it comes to raft foundation, which I'll also show you on that. Okay, so see you then later. So right now you cannot see that I am done with my beam insertion for the foundation. So to now see it very, very clearer, I'll go right now and turn off this grid line so they can see it very clearer. So if I turn this grid line right now, you can now see that our foundation beam right now is now showing very, very clear. Now I'll also navigate now to the 3D view of this interface. So if I now click here right now, you will now see that this is now the beam wrap foundation. As you can see, we have just modeled our foundation beams. As you can see that. Now the next thing now is now model our raft slab. As you can see, now there is a way you can model your foundation slab, which is your raft slab. It's not like the way we used to model normal slab, okay? Because we are going to apply the level for it and all that. So we're doing this right now. I'll be showing you this on the next part of this video because we are already 17 minutes ahead. And I don't want this video to be more than more than 19 minutes. So right now you gonna see the first stage of when you want to model or design for a raft foundation, basically a beam raft foundation. The first thing is for you to now go and set your bearing capacity, which is very, very important, and then now begin to now model for your beams, okay, which you have seen me model, and you can be able to choose your right depth and your right width of your raft beam and all that. Now on the next part right now, I'll begin to show you how to insert slab for this raft foundation, which is not the same way we insert our our slab when it comes to superstructure, but for the substructure is very, very different and all that. So on the part two of this design, for this raft foundation design, you'll be seeing us progress to the next stage, and on the part three will now be on the foundation slab analysis, which we are going to use the FE method, which is a finite element method, okay? So I will say again that if you are new on Ekidel, consider subscribing to our channel Ekidel here. And if you are an old subscriber that have watched our videos, I know by now you are good. Now, to now enhance yourself very much, I would advise you enroll for our Ekidel mentorship class. That should be among your goal as you're entering the next 2024 to enhance yourself on structural design, because there are most things that you are meant to learn that we might not be able to say on this our free YouTube channel here. So then, and also if you're also new on Ekidel and you want to enroll for that, you can get the link down below and enroll for that. You can also join our global WhatsApp group down below, which the link is down below. So see you again on the part two of this raft foundation design for this six-story building. Bye for now and see you again. Bye. Thank you.